All right, welcome back. We are live here on TNT. If we were not live, we would have edited out some of the language in that interview from the Nature Boy Rick Flair. I want to apologize on behalf of WCW for that. And Mongo, I want to apologize. I mean, the things he said out there, there was no call for it.
Maybe part of my plan should be washing his mouth out with soap.
I'd vote for that one. But right now, we have got Bobby Heenan, the man who everybody has been doubting, including you, for a long time, Lex Luger. This is third time. Will it be a charm here tonight against this monster, 7'4", 440-plus pounds, the biggest man in professional wrestling today, make no mistake about it.
He may be the biggest man in professional sports. There's some basketball players that are 7'7", but they don't weigh what this man weighs.
Look at Luger. Luger, one of the most powerful athletes in our sport, bouncing off this behemoth like a rubber ball. A clothesline. He didn't even have to take a step into that clothesline. He just muscled Luger down like a child.
It's unbelievable, the mass and strength of this man. I mean, a sportsman, Lex Luger stands head and shoulders above a normal man. And look at the giant. I'll tell you something, Luger's got probably the greatest opportunity of anybody right now, because he's in there with the champion of the world, and he can beat this man. Luger has those kind of credentials, but he can't listen to Sting. I don't care what Sting has told him. I know Sting probably talked to him. But have you noticed lately, they've even been arguing. They can't even have a discussion without yelling at each other.
Running clothesline by Lex Luger. Lex Luger trying to take this giant off of his feet. No can do. Uh-uh. He gets caught like a fly on paper. Look at this. He is a monster. He is just too much human being to handle.
Right in the small of the back, too. I don't care what kind of shape you're in, like Luger. You get a man 440 pounds, 7'4", running across that ring and driving the small of your back into the top of that rope. That's why that man right there is the champion.
Well, baby, you've got to watch and learn. And you know how the Stinger takes him on? He goes right for that weak link down there. You take the man's legs out, he's going to fall like a giant.
Weak link? He's got legs like oak trees. Well, that's his weak link. Everybody in WCW is in a whole heck of a lot of trouble.
They are, because that is the weakest link, and that's saying something.
What is the weak link to this man, the giant? Probably he hasn't been in the ring that long.
Look at that. Oh, man, if Luger hits him, look at that.
Nothing.
That massive forearm that has served Luger so well for so long. The forearm that took Yokozuna off his feet and knocked him out for 10 minutes not that long ago. And he ricochets off this monster, the giant, like I said earlier, a rubber ball. And then the giant picks him off and tosses him
right over that top rope from the floor. Stands there and presses.
And look
Luger.
At this. Look at this. The Nature Boy.
The champagne flowing. Heavy R's. Fine ladies.
It's like he's got nothing to worry about. Look at that.
Oh, that's his VIP section.
Did you see the giant? A push to the face sends Luger all the way across the ring. Luger coming back. Shoulders into the midsection. Trying to soften this big man up. Trying to knock the wind out of him. Going for the solar plexus.
He and better bring him in that ring, though.
Big back front leg around kick. Another one of those massive bone-crushing forearms, a steel plate in the forearm of Lex Luger from that motorcycle accident a few years ago, and absolutely no effect on the giant.
Oh, look out, sports fans. He's got the man by the neck.
Look out! No. He's got him!
He's rooted the man that wrecked the buffet.
Luger!
This is a new meaning to breaking bread.
Breaking bread? Breaking neck, and look at
it! He goes right through the table.
Oh!
Oh my goodness. That's devastating.
That is Lex Luger laying there on the floor, jammed through a table. Flair going over the rail.
Look at Flair. He's scared to death. The women are scared to death. Jimmy Hart trying to stop the joint. Somebody stop this. This is carnage. This is carnage. Stop it. Stop it now.
Macho's not the only one going berserk around here.
There's Sting.
Stop it now. Stinger out.
Stinger's
come to the aid of his best friend, Lex Luger.
Lex Luger has proved to the world.
He may have his back.
He is a stand-up guy, but it did him absolutely no good. He has just been destroyed by this lunatic 440-pound psycho. Sit demented.
A choke slam through a table? Oh. They might have to get the EMS out here. Get that man a stretcher.
I'll tell you, Luger's not moving too well. He's been on that floor for quite some time now. He is hurt.
Oh, man.
Well, you see that, Bishop? He picked him up by the neck with one hand and drove him through that table.
I don't know. This is not good. This is not good.
Even though this happened to him, baby, I have new respect for Lex Luger. He camped out outside, and he came in here and stood up.
If there has been any doubt about the intentions, the integrity of Lex Luger, he put them to rest tonight.
Get out of here, Gene. Not right now, Gene. Get out of here.
Gene Okerlund trying to find out, but this is obviously not.
Well, maybe Luger now can team up with Billy Ray Cyrus and sing about his achy breaky back.
Shut up, Heenan.
Talking to me?
Yeah, I'm talking to you.
Well, I know I heard two distinct thuds. One when he was being driven through that table, and another one when he hit that concrete floor. That can't be good for you.
Well, he needs some help. He needs it bad.
All right, let's hear.
Have mercy.
Well, I'll talk if nobody else says.
Devastation. Devastation.
When's the last time you saw a man, 275 pounds like Lex Luger, the total package, man who has held every title imaginable at WCW all over the world, picked up by his neck, picked up a good 6.5 to 7 feet in the air, and jammed through a table right at the feet of Ric Flair, woman, and Miss Elizabeth.
Well, I'll tell you what, if Sting needed motivation for Slamboree coming up, if he needed that extra push, he got it tonight. But the image that is going to be burned into his mind when he steps into that ring 6 days from now at Slamboree for a shot at that world title is going to be the image of his best friend picked up straight up in the air with one hand, driven through a table onto the concrete floor. And I don't know if it's motivation or just absolute fear.
You're wrong about that. He can't go in that match thinking in his mind about his busting a buddy laying on the floor. You got to worry about your own carcass, your own back, and your own backside. And you know that man, that 7'4" man across from you, is the man you've got to beat to become champion of the world. Don't worry about your partner on some bedpan in some hospital. Worry about yourself. That's what he's got to do. And you know it.
Steve, it's coming up this weekend. Slamboree exclusively on pay-per-view. If you haven't ordered it in the past, do it. This year is going to be an exceptional event. Make no mistake about it. Sting going after the Giant, the world heavyweight title on the line. The Lethal Lottery, Battle Ball. Forget about it. We are running out of time. We'll see you next time right here on Nitro. Look at this.
I just got word.
Oh, man.
Ah. Oh.